いただきます。
Konnichiwa, everybody. This is Nathan and Will Butcher. We're in Brooklyn, New York, and this is going to be the first step of the My Ultimate Sweat test. Number two, first stop is Gin in Brooklyn, New York. Over the next 2 days, we're just going to go to as many different places as we can and eat a bunch of Japanese food and speak Japanese to as many people who will talk to us. It should be fun. We'll see how it goes. You ready?
Let's do it. All right. All
right. I need a menu, but I don't know the word for menu. So let's hold on. So let's see. Menu wa nihongo de nani desu ka? Is that
yeah?
So
I'm asking me what menu is.
Yes, sir.
In Japanese, and it's very easy. It's just menu.
Oh, menu.
Yeah, they sound it out.
Yeah. Menu. So it's like the katakana version of it. So it's menu or kusai? Menu.
Menu. I want the menu.
We did successfully ask for a menu. I think.
Yes. I mean, clearly we got menus.
We got menus. We communicated.
So we got some squid, takuan, pickles,
yeah, and some fried
tofu.
Fried tofu. Yeah. Okay, but so in Japan, before you eat a meal, there's this tradition. Would you call this a tradition?
Yeah, it's definitely a cultural thing.
Yeah,
you give thanks for your food before you eat it.
Okay, and so the phrase is just
itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu.
Yep. It's just an announcement that you're receiving something and that you're acknowledging your appreciation for it.
All right. So, and then do we clap or something fun?
Yeah. You just like very lightly, just like.
Itadakimasu. Itadakimasu. So this is octopus. It is. I guess like ceviche basically in wasabi and sets in wasabi I think for a long period of time. So it's a little spicy, but it makes the octopus not so tough.
It's good.
It's spicy, but yeah.
Oh, yeah, the pig too. That's good.
We know we're doing the omakase right when they come with the big fish head on the table, right?
Yeah, no kidding.
It worked.
Man, they just brought us the omakase, the sushi.
We're gonna now ask what kind of fish this is.
この魚は何ですか？
ヒラメ。
Hirame, which is what? Halibut.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Round up.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
And I think I asked it correctly.
You did?
Okay, great.
Clearly, because he answered you.
He answered. We communicated. All right, so I want to get some more tea.
Okay.
I know that the word for tea is ocha.
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 But if. Because you've already had tea, what you're looking for is a refill.
Mm-hmm.
And this can be used for food or drink. It's a term called okawari.
Okawari.
Yeah.
Okawari.
Okawari.
Okay, I can actually see that too. Like I can kind of get a gist of what that looks like.
Okawari. Yes, really.
Ocha o okawari okawari kudasai.
We did it. Again.
Cheers. We're communicating. Go, yeah, kanpai. But do you do that with
kanpai.
Tea? Kanpai with tea? Yeah. Alright, so this is some otoro, some fatty tuna. Kanpai.
Kanpai.
Yep. That's why you save it for last. Mm.
Just like there's a phrase for when you're about to
eat your food. Mm. It's also a phrase for when you're done with your meal.
Oh,
have you learned this phrase yet?
No.
Okay. I don't know if you come across it. It's gochisousama.
Oh, gochisousama deshita.
Oh, so you know this phrase.
I do know this phrase.
Same thing at the end of your meal. Gochisousama deshita. And it's just saying, acknowledging that your meal was good and that you're thankful.
Mm. So yeah, I have used this phrase sometimes when like speaking to a chef, right? And I want to let them know that my meal was good.
Saying gochisousama to a chef is that same acknowledgement of that I really just enjoyed myself and this was something special.
Yeah.
So
awesome.
And then you also use it for yourself. I'm done eating. Gochisousama deshita.
Right. Alright, we'll see you at the next spot. I think we're gonna be eating fried meats and stews. So I'm looking forward to that too. You ready to go eat some more?
I'm definitely ready.
Alright. This is the second stop at this restaurant. It's not sushi. It's a sake-based menu primarily, but a lot of different kind of like traditional home kind of cooked Japanese foods. And so we're gonna order some beef that we get to cook on stones. What is that called?
That's Miyazaki gyu.
Miyazaki
gyu.
Gyu. Let's dig in.
All right. Itadakimasu.
Konnichiwa, everybody. Here with Will Butcher, Ricky, Rady GCO. We're just gonna eat some sushi in Brooklyn. It was Ricky's birthday this week. What's up?
Hey.
So.
Yeah,
thank you for having us. So, Random got to be here randomly.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so we're gonna eat some sushi now.
You're out of rice.
Oh, and we want to ask for a refill of rice?
Yep.
I know the rice part. It's the kawari. Kawari.
Throw it together.
I have to think about the particle. So the particle is o, kawari, kurusai.
All, and then say it all together.
So, gohan o.
Yeah,
kawari, kurusai.
Boom.
Somebody stabbed.
There you go.
I got a refill of rice. All right, so we just ordered some curry in addition to a whole bento box. Because, as Jimmy likes to say, I eat twice as much as every other human being on the planet. I'm really excited. All right, let's do it. Konnichiwa, everyone. We are once again at a new spot. We're looking for some more food. I think all we've done is eat the entire weekend. But we're in Little Tokyo in Manhattan now. We're gonna hunt around for some things to eat, and I think we're gonna have a good time. Will, are you ready back there?
Let's do it.
All right, let's go.
Taiyaki, tai being the name of the fish, yaki of course just being like fried. It's a common like festival food in Japan. You can put anything that you want in there, pretty much roast anything. Inside ours we've got red bean paste, adzuki.
Okay, and then this is what we came for.
Yeah, we're here for the okonomiyaki, which is here on the left. It is a savory pancake with pork, savory sauce, mayonnaise, bonito flakes, and cabbage makes up the pancake itself.
Right, and this is the thing I didn't know I was coming for, but I'm really excited about.
Yeah, takoyaki on the right. It's a dough fried ball with a piece of octopus in the center, and then a similar treatment to the okonomiyaki. Flakes, savory sauce, and mayo.
Okay, stop stopping me from eating food now. Konbanwa. Okay, we're at the end of a long day two of going around all of New York and visiting as many places that we can to go and speak Japanese with people. I'm tired, and I bet Will is tired as well. And, you know, it's been a great opportunity to really test my skills. And the last thing we have to do is work on directions. So tomorrow morning, we're going to go to Grand Central Station in New York City. And I'm going to ask some directions of Will, and we're going to see if I can follow directions in Japanese. So, all right, let's go. Konnichiwa, everybody. So this is day three of us going around and testing our Japanese skills in New York City. How are you feeling, Will?
Feeling good, man. You ready for the final test?
Right, so the final part of the test is directions. So we've been eating a lot of food. We've been introducing ourselves to people. We've been talking to a lot of people. But today we're going to go from Grand Central Station here to a Tokyo-style barbershop, which is about 5 or 6 blocks away. And Will's going to give me directions in Japanese. And I'm hopeful that I can actually follow them. And then I'm really hopeful that I actually get a haircut there. All right, so let's go.
Yeah, maybe I'll see you there.
Oh, maybe. So Will, how are we getting there?
All right, instruction number one. Ready for it?
I'm ready.
Masugu itte, niji magatte, Chrysler bir ni tomatte.
Okay, so the instructions are we're going to go straight and then turn right, and then we're going to go straight until we get to the Chrysler building.
Let's do it.
All right, let's see. Let's see if we can actually make this happen. All right, let's go. All right, everybody, we're starting at Park Avenue and 41st Street, and we're supposed to go straight down Park Avenue and then Miyagi, which is right, and then we're going to turn right onto 42nd Street. So let's go. So I think he said we're going to go to the Chrysler building and meet him there. This is the Chrysler building. He said a word in his instructions that I don't know, which is something like tomate or something to that effect. So we're going to ask him when we get there. I think it means like a corner or stop or something. All right. So we've completed step one of the directions. We have gone straight on Park Avenue, and then there's Will waving, and then we turned right onto 42nd Street so that we could come here and we could meet Will at stop number one. So we were talking while we were away from you, and you used a word at the end of your description that I didn't know, which is like something like stop or place. What is that? What is this phrase?
Tamaru.
Tamaru. Tamaru. Tamate.
Command form. Stop.
Ah.
So I asked you to go straight, turn right, stop at the Chrysler building.
So
here you are.
All right. So what is step two in the instructions, and where are we going next?
All right. Your second step. 43rd通り.
Yeah.
右曲がって.
Okay, so 43rd is 43, so that's 43rd Street, and we're taking a right on 43rd Street. I think I did it. I think we're going to do this one. All right, so are we going to meet you at the next spot? Is that what we're doing?
Yep.
All right, let's do it. 43rd is 43. So we're walking down to 43rd Street. Do you remember all of those words of the day we were counting? They're paying off right now where we can actually hear a number and go to that street. As you can see here, 43rd Street. Okay, and so we're turning right on 43rd Street. Now the real test is, I don't actually know where I'm meeting him. Ah, so he said, I didn't catch this before, but he was saying he would be on the left side. Oop, I see him. I see Will up here. We did it! Look, we found Will. And he's at the barbershop. All right, so we did it. So,
consider this a massive success.
I mean, you know, we walked a couple blocks. We made it to the haircut shop. And, you know, now it's time to get a haircut, right?
So I'm doing a competition and attempting to learn as much
Japanese as I can in 12 weeks.
Oh wow, so you need to practice here then.
I need to practice.
It's free practice.
Free practice.
You need to stand
there and yeah, that's practice. Right, that's how we ended up here. I was speaking to somebody recently and I mean, it's very simple, right? I just like, hajimemashite.
Right.
And then I just said like, Nissan to moshimasu. And just a little bit into that, they were just like, shocked. And then they just started talking to me so fast
that they think that you just
yeah, they think that I was fluent. Yeah, so yeah. They just speak so much, I was like, oh no, 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 I'm gonna slow down.
Also, ikara? What is ikara?
Ikura. Yeah. Ah, ikura. How much?
Yeah.
Ikura.
Tell me.
20.
Oh, okay.
Receipt, irimasu ka?
Irimasen.
Oh. Yeah.
Like holy shit, we did it.
We did it.
We followed directions.
Nice haircut.
We got a haircut. I'm feeling good about it. We had a great conversation. Mm-hmm. We got to use a little bit of Japanese. We got to use a lot of Japanese.
That's fun.
I can count a little bit. I knew how to ask how much it was. I was really excited about that. I knew to say no to getting a receipt. I feel like a lot of successes today. Wow, I can't believe it. It's like we're kind of wrapping this thing up. This whole thing is finally coming to an end. I've been able to test my skills pretty intensely at this point.
And I kind of just want to say congratulations almost.
Wow, yeah, I know, right?
We set out to do this, and I mean, both of us knew from the very beginning it was a significant undertaking.
Yeah.
And you put in a ton of work, and it's been really fun to finally, you know, administer these tests. See the result of it,
right?
Yeah. And put it to like real life application.
Yeah,
you're just doing it.
Can I just say like thank you to you? But can I ask you like when we started this process, did you think we would get to the place where you would be in New York City and we would actually be practicing Japanese in real life with real people in real time?
I don't think I thought all of that was gonna happen.
Right.
I thought I could get you to a good place where we could accomplish what you were looking for.
Right.
But if you told me that I would be here doing it with you and actually giving you the test myself in person, I don't know if I expected that to happen.
I mean, I have to say from my perspective, I couldn't have found a better way to have my ultimate spec come to an end, because since you've been teaching me, you've seen the real progress that I've made over time.
Absolutely.
And I think that it's been really surprising to me, even though I set up these goals to be able to introduce myself, to be able to order food and to ask for directions and understand them. I know those were simple goals, but now like that we're actually doing it and I've actually been able to perform those actions, it's even kind of surprising and shocking to me. So thank you so much for all of your help.
Absolutely. You've done great, to be honest.
I really couldn't have done it without you. And you know, thanks to everybody who's been watching. I'll have one more video in the coming week without beeping sounds from a truck, in which I will be closing out the whole experience and saying, you know, everything that's kind of coming to an end. Arigatou gozaimasu, and mata ne.
Mata ne.